しい天ぷらを揚げさせていただくには食材というものがかなり重要なポイントでございます。日本には四季があります。大きく分ければ4つありますが、春の中でも2つから3つの旬があると思っています。全ての季節においても美味しい食材が、旬というものは本当に一瞬であると、そういう思いを胸に、本当に今何が一番美味しいのか、それを考えながらいろんな関係者の方と業者様とタッグを組ませていただいて食材を確保するに努めております。
Hey Nicole.
Yeah.
Have you ever tried Japanese cuisine before?
Yeah, I have things like sushi, ramen, and of course in Kansai, okonomiyaki, takoyaki.
Awesome. So, have you ever tried tempura?
Yeah, I've had a few times.
Awesome.
I like it.
So actually, we are going to a 2-star tempura restaurant located in Suita, Osaka. And it is owned by Chef Tsuchisaka-san.
Nice.
And his cuisine is well known for being robust and just out of this world.
Okay.
And the hospitality is top-notch.
Okay, all right.
I'm quite excited, actually.
Yeah, I've never really thought of tempura as one of my favorite Japanese foods, but now that you say that, I'm looking forward to it.
Cool. Wow, look at this. It's amazing.
It looks like Kyoto.
Yeah, it's like proper Japanese style house.
Yeah, I felt very welcome. The atmosphere, even outside of the restaurant, it's really a beautiful place. And there's this lovely garden right here. Yeah, the atmosphere even before you walk in is very comforting. And then the staff and even the chef himself were waiting for me, so I felt very, very welcome. I think Japan is well known for its really great customer service and hospitality. And then this was on another level though, because I didn't only feel acknowledged, but I felt like a very warm greeting when I was here. Like they were very happy to have me here.
天ぷらとは、食材に小麦粉を使いました薄い衣をまとわせて、高温の油ですね、それで一気に加熱して仕上げる料理でございます。至ってシンプルな調理法でありながら、その奥行きはとても深く、ただ揚げるだけじゃなくて蒸しながら揚げる、焼きながら揚げる、時間をかけて余熱を通す、いろいろな調理法があります。もちろんいろんな食材を使うものですから、一つ一つの食材に衣の薄さ、油の温度、揚げる時間、これは全て違います。その全て違う動作をしながら、その一つ一つの食材の香り、旨味、全てを頂点に持っていく、これが天ぷら職人の仕事でございます。
I was very impressed with the presentation for one, and also the fact that there were different alcohol pairings with each dish, so that made me think a lot about the flavors inside of the food, becauseOf course, there are certain flavors that would pair with something else. So I was really impressed with how well everything was paired together. And I also enjoyed the fact that we had a few minutes in between each dish. So you could really take the time to think about it and kind of get excited for the next dish.
That's so refreshing.
That's really nice. It's lighter than it looks.
数ある天ぷらのネタの中でエビは代表の一つであると思います。コースの中でも私は一番最初にエビを揚げさせていただきます。私の技術はこうですよというものをお客様に知っていただきたいからであります。甘み、香り、旨味が抜群でございます。その香りにミネラルたっぷりのシャンパーニュを合わせていただきまして、長い余韻となってとても美味しく感じます。日本のトウモロコシの糖度はとても高いです。甘みの強いトウモロコシの天ぷらにすっきりとした白ワインを合わせていただきますと、トウモロコシの甘さが余計に際立ち美味しく感じます。
I really like this one.
Yeah. Like, I wish I could bring home some.
I wish I could do this myself at home.
Oh, so good.
Wow, you should take another sip of the wine. So the dish that had the most impact on me would be the uni, which is something I didn't expect. That was the only food that we had today that was not cooked. So it stood out for that reason, but it was also paired with the perilla leaf, and it just was a really nice combination together. So I think now, because uni was originally something that I wouldn't eat, my impression of it really changed to be a positive one.
ウニの天ぷらはウニに火入れをしておりませんので、生の状態でございます。日本酒と合わせていただいて、お作りを召し上がっていただいているような感覚にもなります。
It's good with the sake. Yeah.
It's the perfect way to finish it off.
Yeah.
With the sip of this.
Wow. I'm amazed at it.That is just beautiful. Wow.
Wow.
It's like art.
Yeah, this should go in a museum.
I know, right? It's like
this
presentation is... like you want to take a picture of it, you know?
ビアコさんの鮎を氷で締めた後、きれいに揚げます。鮎が泳いでいる風景を想像していただくようにさせていただいております。鮎の香り、苦味が特徴でございます。その、苦味に、赤ワイン、タンニンしっかりめの赤ワインを合わせていただくとすごく合います。
Did you enjoy the meal?
Yeah, this whole experience has been so nice.
Me too.
And the food is perfect. Thank you so much.
天ぷらは、日本を代表する料理の一つだと思っております。おかげさまで世界中からたくさんのお客様が日本へお越しいただいて、たくさんのお料理を召し上がっていただいていると思います。ぜひとも日本にお越しいただきまして、土屋をお選びいただきまして、私の目の前のカウンターで熱々の天ぷらを召し上がっていただきまして、最高の旬の食材を、そして最高のおもてなしとともに土屋を楽しんでいただけましたら幸いでございます。